to the NBA Rising Stars Challenge, as we'll see the best and the brightest young players in the NBA face off with Clark Kellogg and Steve Kerr. This is Kevin Hart.
You know, guys, this Rising Stars Challenge, in my mind, is a really good opportunity for young players to make a statement and separate themselves from their peers a little bit.
And so off the tip, it's the Stars. Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. On the court right now for the Stars. We've got Parker. Stauskas is out there with Exum. Then there's Plumlee, and it's Stokes in at the four spot. Going back to that recognition aspect, Clark, a very good one. I think the very fact that these players have been invited to play out of a group of, what, 100 is praise in itself.
No question about it.
Yeah, if you're in your first or second season, I mean, this is where you want to be. There's a lot of prestige that comes with being named to play in this game, and obviously the next step beyond this is the All-Star game.
That's good. Oladipo's got himself on the board with three there.
And we're seeing right here the defense is definitely optional.
Yeah, and we're seeing which option the players are taking. Very lax defense. Both teams are just getting a sweat going. They haven't really got into the defense yet.
Well, Steve, you've watched these games before. That's not a big surprise. Saving some of that energy for the offensive fireworks is what they're doing.
Just a fun event to see so much talent here assembled in one place.
Well, it's really one of the reasons this weekend is such a fun time for the fans and really all of the NBA players involved as well. You know, this Rising Stars Challenge, really one of my favorite events, but I think it has potential to be even better if the teams would be committed to playing more like a regular game. I understand the entertainment value. That's important. But let's be a little more committed to playing the way they typically play. And I think that would add great value because you have such tremendous talent out there, hungry, talented, impressive players.
Very well said, Clark. Very well said. Wasted no time on that one. 6 points for Andrew Wiggins.
How in the world did they let him get that wide open?
Exum kicks to Stauskas. Feeds it to Exum. Passes to Stauskas. Elbow shot is on the way. And the basket by Stokes. The Rising Stars Challenge, really a great way for the league in theory to introduce fans to some of the great talent, Steve, coming into the NBA.
Yeah, I mean, these guys may not be household names just yet, but this is a part of the process. You know, playing in this game is an honor, and for these young guys to get the chance to showcase their talents here at All-Star Weekend and just get a taste of what's out there for them if they can really improve and make it to the big show.
Catching up now on the changes for the Elites. Adams, he's checked in for Gobert. Embiid comes in for Zeller. Hardaway's checked in for Victor Oladipo. And Levine subbed in for Trey Burke. Looking at who's out there now for the Stars. And Antetokounmpo's checked in for Stokes. And Smart subbed in for Exum. And the Stars have possession. The Elites able to drain the three.
Well, you start to see why he's been such a key player in the first half of the season.
Yeah, he's getting really big minutes, and he's more than ready.
That's good. 8 points for Andrew Wiggins.
And not a whole lot of defensive resistance.
Well, if you like defense, don't watch this game.
In the corner, Smart with it. Pass to Noel. And the layup's good off the glass. Noel's got his first 2 points of the night.
You know, when the size advantage is that pronounced, I mean, that's exactly what you should do offensively in this situation. Take it strong to the middle. And they've set up countless buckets off assists. That's a huge part of what they've been doing here today. A
lot of dime dropping going on out there, Steve.
Now here's Parker. An easy layup after coming off the pick. Parker's got his second bucket of the night.
You know, they've been so effective when they've been able to get the ball inside.
Some real shortcomings from this defense. I mean, they've given up 5 straight looks in the paint. The D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. 3 of the last 5 baskets they've allowed have been of the 3-point variety.
Yeah, and unless they make some rotations and closeouts defensively, there's more to come, Clark.
Smart, wide open, he fires. And it's good on the assist by Parker.
Right back at you. They immediately get those 3 points back.
Trading punches, that's how you answer.
Well, it's been a high-scoring competitive game through the first quarter of play. Leads ahead, up by 2. And don't go away. We'll be back with the action for the start of the second quarter in just a moment.
Uh-huh. Yo, Next Thursday night, February 19th, Dirk Nowitzki and the Dallas Mavericks take on Kevin Durant and the Oklahoma City Thunder. Hoops action.
Welcome back to the Rising Stars Challenge, a showcase for the up-and-coming stars of the NBA.
These young guns showing us what they can do right now.
And so much great young talent coming into the league. No better place to see it than right here.
Not too surprising to have so few fouls here.
Yeah, you know what? I think part of it is the officiating, Steve. They get a little more leeway from the officials to the players, but some credit has to go to the players as well. I mean, no need to be overly aggressive in this kind of game format.
Levine is out there with Oladipo. Then there's Tim Hardaway Jr. And then there's Steven Adams. And it's Jang in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the group for the Elites to start this second quarter.
Well, one thing we're noticing here tonight,
both teams pretty much taking care of the ball, which is impressive in a game like this.
Yeah, it really is, Steve. I mean, typically in a game like this, the players and teams can be a little loose, but that hasn't been the case so far.
And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time. The whistle blowing. And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Elites?
Now, they didn't waste any time getting into a groove out there. They're dialed in from long range.
They've been distributing the ball really well tonight, too. I mean, a decent number of assists so far for them.
Zeller is checked in for the Elites. Trey Burke comes in for Levine. The Stars also changing it up. Zauskas comes in for Smart. And it's Exum in for Carter Williams. That one's good, and the Elite lead is cut down now to just four in the basket from Stauskas.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Yeah, that's five of their last six baskets inside the lane. They have really established themselves inside.
A nice shot by Zeller. Exum with it. Out to the right wing. Takes a three. Stauskas' shot is off.
Nobody near him. He'll normally make that one.
Shot from 12. Bounces high off the rim and drops. Hardaway has got 7 points here in this quarter.
Look out, guys. I mean, I think there's a lot more where that came from. When he gets it going like this, it is not easy to slow him down.
Bogdanovich, no luck. The Elites leading by 8. Inside. And there's Hardaway. That's good on the assist by Oladipo. Hardaway has got 14.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
Yeah, they have the defense on the run right now because every pass seems to have a purpose. They're getting great movement, great spacing, and they're really lining them up defensively.
And the Elites will go with a different look here. Gobert, he's checked in for Gorgui Dieng. Embiid comes in for Zeller. Wiggins is checked in for Tim Hardaway Jr. And Levine subbed in for Victor Oladipo. Then for the Stars, Noel's checked in for Plumlee. Parker comes in, and Antetokounmpo subbed in for Bogdanovich. Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
During that break, Dwayne Casey had some words for his team. Back to fundamentals, that's what he told them. Specifically, he'd like to see them implement the pick and roll as often as possible. He also wants his players putting pressure on the defense with early offense. Lots of shots and an aggressive approach in general whenever they've got the ball. Being in the position they're in, probably a smart move to go to the clipboard and switch things up while we're still in the first half. Kevin?
Thanks, Doris. Hits, count that one from Stauskas.
Now, sometimes when you trail, you want to make up that entire deficit with one shot. I think they've got to be more patient.
Yeah, there are no home run shots in basketball. I know the three is a big weapon. But all these threes haven't helped their cause, so they're trying to catch fire from there and just haven't been able to do it.
Here's Exum after the Elites pick up two. The tray, that one's good, and the Elite lead is cut down to 7 on the bucket from Stauskas.
And he's shaken off a poor first quarter shooting effort. He's really starting to turn it on now, guys.
And that one's good.
They've done a lot of good work with the ball, really moving both the ball and moving bodies. Quality chances at the hoop.
And they're not wasting chances when they get them. I mean, they're hitting their shots.
Exum's shot is off. And here comes Wiggins. Here's Embiid. Offensive rebound. Gobert. And it's good. But hold on. The officials may want to look at that one on the replay monitor. And we are not going to halftime just yet. Officials signaling they are going to review the tape.
And now that we've gotten a chance to see it in slow motion, I think the ruling has to be that he did not beat the buzzer with that shot.
Yeah, I agree, Clark. He wasn't quick enough on his release, it would appear. Looks like the ball was still in his fingertips as the clock went off.
Well, the ruling is in, and the call stands. No basket, so no change, Clark, in the scoreboard as we end the quarter.
Smart decision to review the shot. That was indeed very close to being legitimate.
And so that's the end of the first half. Elites lead by 9. And we'll be back for the second half following the break. Keep it right here on 2K Sports. And we're back once again, the spotlight on the talented first and second year players here in the Rising Stars Challenge.
Kevin, so far, spectacular plays all over.
Well, it's the young legs. All that bounce makes for some impressive finishes.
Here's Burke. And on the floor for Dwayne Casey starting the second half. Stauskas is out there with Exum. Then there's Plumlee. Then there's Parker. And it's Stokes in at the four spot.
Yeah, no problem knocking down that shot. And a little more damage inflicted on another defensive lapse.
And the shot is good. 6 points for Jabari Parker.
Now, he's really stood out for his club today. Even though they're struggling a little bit, he's doing his part.
And that one ends up out of bounds. They'll keep possession.
20 seconds of the shot clock.
And the Elites making a change here. Adams checked in. Fires from the line, and that one's good. Wiggins has got the lead up to 11 now for the Elites. Pass to Stauskas, and the layup is good after a nice lead pass. Stauskas has got 11 points.
Sloppy defense there. You can't let him get the ball in his hands down there.
Well, when he does, that's an automatic bucket.
And the basket good.
They've been good on all three of their shots since coming out of the locker room at the break.
Exum kicks to Parker. Here's the screen. Clock at 6. Terrific design on the pick play. And he lays it in. He's got 8.
The second he got around the pick and shook his man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy dude. Very, very well done.
That's 4 straight from the field, guys. Off to a quick start this third quarter.
Now a timeout called by the Stars. Andrew Wiggins really making a difference here.
He's definitely rolling offensively. You might not be able to stop him. But you've got to find a way to contain.
Catching up now on the changes for the Elites. Gorgui Dang comes in for Cody Zeller. And Tim Hardaway Jr. subbed in for Trey Burke. Smarts checked in for the Stars. Carter Williams comes in for Exum. Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Yes, Kevin. Dwayne Casey was just going over the plan with his team. If what he talked about is a true indication, the pick and roll is going to be their go-to play from now on. He sees that as being their best option offensively. He also said something you don't hear too often from a coach. He told his guys they should have a shoot-first mindset instead of trying to be, quote, too cute with the ball. Coach was not wasting any time in altering their strategy here in the second half. And, Kevin, he's going to have to hope those changes take effect quickly.
And thank you for that, Doris. Stokes can't get it to go.
You know, they're not totally dominating the glass, but they're definitely doing enough to keep this lead right where it is.
Well, if you're doing enough good things and you're maintaining at least a slight edge on the boards, you're usually going to be in pretty good shape.
Parker with no one around. Second chance shot, and he sinks the layup. Stokes has got 8.
Kevin, you look at his play throughout the first half of the season, he's really gotten the attention of some folks.
Yeah, making believers out of the skeptics. I mean, his development has really been fun to watch.
Embiid, he's checked in for the Elites. Dean comes in for Victor Oladipo. And then for the Stars, Erlen's Noel checks in for Plumlee. And Antetokounmpo subbed in for Stokes.
Solid work right there. And again, the field goal percentages. Look at the discrepancy between these two teams in the second half.
Well, you're right. We've got one team moving crisply to get good shots and the other team just a bit stagnant.
They'd love to get more of those, the easiest 2 points possible. And on a fierce finish.
Yeah, and that's exactly how they're going to cut into the lead, Kevin.
Yeah, that's why they've got to tighten up their D. And I'd be surprised if the defense allows any more free runs to the roof like that.
Now that's finishing your work right there.
Powerful two-hand, Jim. You're right.
Yeah, if he's got a few more of those in him, this lead will really start shrinking. Well, we've seen that before. I mean, these two teammates hooking up. They've got a lot of chemistry together, no question.
They certainly do, and it's fun to watch. I mean, they really know what each other is thinking.
And he gets it to go. Levine's got his second basket of the night. Now here's Smart. 5 points in the game. Kicks to Parker. Fires from the corner, and the jumper is on the mark. 5 seconds left in the third quarter. 1 second left. Oh, and the buzzer beaters Levine.
That really could be a morale-crushing three-pointer, fellas. What a way to head into the fourth quarter.
Coming up next Thursday, February 19th, Tim Duncan and the San Antonio Spurs take on Chris Paul and the Los Angeles Clippers, live from Los Angeles. You don't want to miss it.
Welcome back, everyone, to the Rising Stars Challenge, where the NBA's youngest, brightest stars take the stage.
And for a lot of these young guys, their first taste of All-Star Weekend.
Yeah, nice way to get their feet wet and motivate them to make it to the big event.
They've got Gobert. Victor Oladipo is out there with Zeller. Then there's Burke. And it's Levine at the shooting guard. That's the group on the floor for the elites. Here's Levine. Here's Burke. Gets the three-pointer to fall.
There's been a huge discrepancy between these teams and their effectiveness from the three-point line.
And you really notice it at that end of the floor where they continue to get open looks and knock them down. That's what has to happen if they're going to turn this thing around. He's got to take charge. He's got to be aggressive and really look to push here offensively. Well, here we go again. An open path to the hoop, an easy 2 points. Where is the defense?
Here's Bogdanović, and he bangs it home with one hand.
Cutting into the lead with a huge one-hand throwdown.
That's how to get your team back into it.
Yes, yeah, sir. That may put a little life back into this team.
He is capable, Clark, of some incredible athleticism.
And we just got a chance to see it on full display right there.
Well, you got to love a point guard who can finish like a power forward.
And the Stars have possession. After the elites pick up two, count that one. First minute and a half of basketball play here in the fourth quarter. Zeller passes to Gobert. He kicks to Zeller. Lays it up and banks it in. And the elites lead by 17. Now a timeout called by the Stars. And the elites with some changes. Adams, he's checked in for Gobert. And Wiggins is subbed in for Levine. And then for the Stars, Mason Plumlee's checked in for Noel. And Stokes subbed in for Bogdanović.
Boy, we don't see that too often. No defender on him, and he just clanks the open jumper.
And again, it's the elites with a three.
Boy, they've come out of halftime just smoking hot from behind the arc.
Hey, trust me on this one, partner. They are going to continue to let him fly.
And he gets it to go.
That's some tenacity inside, battling for the second chance points.
And a wide open look here for Wiggins. And again, it's the elites with a three.
He's a big reason why they have the lead right now. He's made all of his field goal attempts thus far and remains hot from the floor.
And it's slammed in by Plumlee.
Great looking bounce pass to set up that play.
Oladipo dishes to Adams. Plumlee with the block. They recover it. And a wide open look here for Wiggins. That one falls coming off Burke's feet. 31 points for Andrew Wiggins. So it's the Stars now. The pass to Stauskas. Down low, here's Stokes, and the dunk to finish it off. A beauty. No challenge from the defense there. Clark could have put that one through any way he wanted.
And I love the choice there, partner. Going hard to the hoop for that throwdown.
Yeah, that's invisible defense leading to a very visible finish.
And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown for the Elites.
These long-range shots look like layups out there, guys.
Something that also stands out tonight is the number of assists they have. I mean, that's a mark of a good club.
Here's what the Elites have going on right now. Forgy Dangs checked in for Cody Zeller. Hardaway is subbed in for Trey Burke.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
I think it's time to make some adjustments defensively, Clark. I mean, what they've got going right now is not getting it done. It's interesting. They're like a different team now. Suddenly, they've got energy.
You know, it's not going to change anything, though, other than to make their losing margin a little more respectable.
And Oladipo kicks to Wiggins. Oladipo, the pass to Wiggins. Sinks the triple. Wiggins has got 34.
Absolutely on fire from beyond the arc.
Yeah, that's where he's getting his points.
That is good.
A basket by Michael Carter-Williams.
Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Got that bucket in no time at all.
Well, this is going to seal the deal. They've really exploded here to the finish line.
You know, once they sniffed out that blood in the water, the killer instinct came right out.
And guys, they can just sit on the ball here if they want to.
Sure can, because they've earned the win.
So the whistle blows on the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there. And he makes the first. The Elites making a switch here. So he makes one of two as the second one misses. To the middle. Here's Bogdanović. Rebounded by Hardaway.
Got a pretty good look at the basket, but defensively they did a nice job rotating, forcing the miss.
That one goes.
Really shot the ball straight.